Hi, this is Dave from JavaCodeJunkie.com, and in today's video tutorial, we're going to look at the anchor pane in JavaFX. If this is your first time here, or if your goal is to learn all about JavaFX, please take a moment to subscribe and click the bell icon to be notified when I release new videos. An anchor pane layout in JavaFX allows the edges of child nodes to be anchored to an offset from the anchor pane's edges. And what that means is each child can have up to four anchors, and those anchors are top anchor, left anchor, right anchor, and bottom anchor. And when you specify the constraint for one of those four anchors, you specify the node and a distance from the pane to the child in pixels. So let's take a look at that. We'll create an anchor pane and we'll create some controls to play around with. So I'm going to use the no argument constructor to create the anchor pane. And then to save time, I'm just going to paste in some code for a text area and two buttons. Adding the child nodes to the anchor pane is the same as adding any of the child nodes to any of the other panes that we've seen in our previous tutorials. So we'll use the object, and we'll get an observable list of children. And we'll add all of those nodes that we want to add to the anchor pane. We'll add the text area, and button 1, and button 2. Well, let's run that and see what kind of a layout we get for those child nodes without specifying any of the anchor pane constraints for each of the child nodes. As you can see, it's not very pretty. Since we haven't specified any of the constraints for the child nodes, all of the child nodes, the text area and the two buttons, are aligned in the top left of the anchor pane. So they all overlap. So they're on top of one another. So let's go back to our program and we'll add some constraints to the child nodes. We'll start with the text node, and we add the constraints using a static method of the anchor pane class. As you can see here, they're right at the top, the set right, set bottom, set top, and set left anchor methods. So we're going to start with the text area and set the top anchor. And we'll set an offset of 10 pixels from the left of the anchor pane. Let's also set constraints for the two buttons. So we'll start with the open button, or button 1, again, the static method on the anchor pane class. And in this case, I want button 1 to be anchored to an offset from the right of the anchor pane. And to do that, I'm going to set two constraints for button 1. I'm going to set the top anchor and the right anchor, so that the control is always anchored a specific number of pixels from the top and the right in the anchor pane. And for button 2, I'm going to have that anchored to the bottom right-hand corner, so I'm going to set the right and the bottom constraints. So let's run that now that we have some constraints and see how that looks. So at least the buttons look better. They're anchored 10 pixels from the top and right of the anchor pane. We need to do some more work on the text area. So text area, I'm actually going to also set the other three constraints, the left, right, and the bottom. The right anchor, I'm going to move a little further in from the right side so that it doesn't overlap the buttons as we saw when we ran it last time. So I'm going to move it, let's say, 100 pixels from the right. And we'll also set the anchor for the bottom to 10 pixels from the bottom of the anchor pane. Let's run that. And so there you see it looks much better. The controls are actually placed where I wanted them. The text area occupies the area to the left, anchored 10 pixels from the top left and bottom and 100 pixels from the right. Button 1, which is the open button, is anchored 10 pixels from the top and the right. And the close button, which is button number 2, is anchored 10 pixels from the right and the bottom. But if we were to resize at this point, you'll see that everything resizes and the text area actually grows so that it maintains the distance based on its anchor on the top left, bottom, and right. So you can make the layout bigger or smaller and the controls stay where they're supposed to be. That's about it for the anchor pane. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like button and leave any questions or comments in the area below. Also, take a moment to subscribe, and don't forget to click the bell to be notified when I post new videos. Until next time, be safe and keep on coding.